He learned to duck her vicious blows. A young woman who was extremely possessed, about as possessed as someone could seemingly be. And it's a very interesting case because, on the one hand, it's extremely sad, but on the other, it's also quite revealing in a certain number of ways.
Shedding light on a dark situation. She's dead inside, keeps her heart in the basement. The bitterness of life, she started to taste it. She dealt with it in ways that would help her through the days. Her and Helter Skelter just boozing through the gray. That ship sailed, trapped on the trail, attractive and frail, mad with the tale to tell all the world she lived in hell. Jealous of all the girls, without demons she forgot how to sleep.
But around the years 14 or 15 years of age, she began having these problems with apparent demonic activity.
Scared of her own dreams, she stared at the beams. Demons got the schemes, had her releasing the screams. It's taken this to creepy extremes. Reading and trading from the Bible all the while. No, she'll never see another church aisle. All of her art is now a burnt pile. Things weren't smiles, something so vicious inside of a child.
From things that she said and later confided to people, it seems that her problems started around the same time she began maybe getting involved with young men.
It was somewhere near here, one of her fears was a mirror. She was now gone, now she lives without God. Some believed it, some didn't, trying to place the blame. Wants to die and escape pain. Eating spiders, never defeating the demon inside her. Extremely possessed, possessed as could be. No glory, see I know the story, cause she confessed it to me.
This may have resulted from her having fallen into mortal sin in one of those situations, which revealed the extent to which she was possessed, referring to when she was about to enter a Catholic shrine, approached it with the greatest hesitation, then said that the soil burned like fire and she simply could not stand it. She then walked around the shrine in a wide arc and tried to approach it from the back, and it seemed to her that while praying they were gnashing their teeth. She got as far as the edge of the little garden, and she had to turn back.
There's no turning back. She didn't deserve that. Living in the black, ripping plaques in half. Sick and standing backwards, different half. And blackbirds dead full arrows instead of the sparrows. All in her bones, down to the marrow. Chances are narrow behind her eyes. Forever deprived of everything sacred and happiness inside. Emotions were frying, devoted to hiding. So fucking potent, full of thunder and lightning. Wondrous writing.
Home about 2 hours later, we were both convinced more than ever that we were dealing with a case of possession.
Sleep was impossible. Every little follicle considered an obstacle. Vivid and phenomenal. Sins weren't washable. Position was proximal. This wasn't optional. Death was probable. Inspection unsolvable. Was unstoppable. Behavior methodical. Laughing at the priest. This shit wasn't comical. Spirit anatomical. Spirit anatomical.
After the exorcism, her problems did not go away.
Sick and standing backwards, different having blackbirds, dead full of arrows instead of the sparrows. Sick and standing backwards, different having blackbirds, dead full of arrows instead of the sparrows. Sick and standing backwards, different having blackbirds, dead full of arrows instead of the sparrows. Sick and standing backwards, different having blackbirds, dead full of arrows instead of the sparrows.
Heights that no one could possibly have anticipated. Sleep was nearly impossible, allowing her to go to 1 to 2 hours to eat her rest. She rushed through the house, up and down the steps, walking around the village. She knelt down, then got up, again with incredible speed, until her knees swelled and were pulsating. Her coarse, incessant screams, rising and falling like waves scudding against a rocky shore. From the walls. Then a peak would come, she would crumble and twitch, and as a consequence of the enormity of her agitation, she would collapse and complete catatonic-like rigidity, not moving arms or legs, even the screams and laughs would cease for a while, along with her exciting and true muscle power that was close to superhuman. Peter saw her take an apple and effortlessly squeeze it with one hand so that the fragments exploded throughout the room. Fast as lightning, she threw her on the floor as if she were a rag doll. Her neck muscles tensing like bands of steel, she could not swallow any solid food and could take liquids only sometimes. She stuffed flies and spiders into her mouth, tried to chew on a coal. Love became hate. Her family learned to duck her vicious blows. Power that was close to superhuman. Close to superhuman. Power.